Hello, my name is Vivian Monson and I'm a PhD student in Alex Bateman Group at the European Bioinformatics Institute MBL-EBI in Hinxton. The title of my poster presentation is The Discovery and Investigation of Fimbria Adhesins in Bacterial Proteomes. So what are Fimbria Adhesins? Fimbria Adhesins is one class of adhesive proteins by which bacteria can mediate their attachment to the host cell. The name Fimbria adhesins is based on their fibrillar structure, and this again is based on their characteristic stalk. This stalk is composed out of repeating protein domains, which we call stalk domains, and which fold in a way that they build this elongated structure, which can be seen as fibrils on the bacterial surface. The stalk is assumed to project the adhesive domain away from the bacterial surface. You can see examples of fibrilla adhesins from Staphylococcus aureus in the concept figure on the left side of my poster. The aim of my PhD project is to computationally detect these fibrilla adhesins in bacterial proteomes. But therefore, I firstly need to characterize them, whereby I concentrate on the following three main questions, which are: which stalk and adhesive domains are found in combination? Secondly, how can the protein architecture of fimbria adhesins be characterized? And thirdly, how widely are these proteins distributed in nature and how did they evolve? Based on the adhesive and stalk domains, I could find more than 1,000 fimbria adhesins-like proteins in the UniProt Reference Proteomes database. On the heat map at the bottom left, you can see all found possible combinations out of adhesive and stalk domains which we found in these proteins. On the y-axis, there are the adhesive domains and on the x-axis, the stalk domains. You can see that there are adhesive domains which can be found in combination with a wide range of different stalk domains, but there are also adhesive domains which are only found in a combination with one specific stalk domain. But how are these domains actually arranged in the protein? So I had a closer look at the protein architecture. You can see in the density plots at the white at the top, there I plotted the adhesive and stalk domain positions, whereby the density plot in the left are for the gram-positive bacteria and on the right for gram-negative bacteria. The domain positions for adhesive domains are in red and the one for stalk domains in blue. The x-axis represents the protein, whereby 0 stands for the N-terminus and 100 for the C-terminus. I also was interested to see which anchor domains or motifs I can find, and the results I plotted in the heat map below the density plots, whereby I distinguish between the fühler with the most fibrillar adhesin-like protein hits. And so for gram-positive bacteria, the adhesive domain is clearly positioned mainly at the N-terminus and the stalk domain at the C-terminus. In the heat map, you can then see that for the gram-positive Firmicutes or actinobacteria, mainly the sortase motifs were found, which are in general at the C-terminus and also include, for example, the well-known LPXTG motif. So this result supports the assumption that the adhesive domain is at the N-terminus and at the top of the stalk, which then is anchored or attached to the bacterial cell surface, and so can project the adhesive domain away from the bacterial cell surface. Contrary to this are the results for the gram-negative bacteria, which are not that clear, because they also include, for example, the ATX adhesino inverse autotransporters, which are attached by the N-terminus to the cell surface and have the adhesive domain at the C-terminus. In my third point, by analyzing the distributions of fibrillar adhesins, I want to gain information to better explain the signal functions of fimbria adhesins, for example, if they are well adapted to one bacterial species into its environment. But also I want to gain information to find new pimpilatacenes, for example in one species based on a very close related species. Additionally, we saw in different bacterial genera pimpilatacenes with the same adhesive domain but with different stalk domains, or vice versa. So we want to investigate further how the pimpilatacenes evolved and how the domains could be transferred between the different bacterial genera. I hope I could give you an overview about my work, and if you have any questions, comments or feedback, please let me know. You can find my email at the bottom right. And with this, I would like to thank you for your attention.